medal. And in women's 3-on-3 basketball, the USA beat Russia for the gold. And Americans Richard Torres Jr. and Keyshawn Davis settled for silver medals in boxing on the final day at Tokyo. Torres lost to Uzbekistan's Bekhudor Jalilov by unanimous decision in the super heavyweight division. Davis fell to Cuba's Andy Cruz in the lightweight final. Team USA is leaving Tokyo with the most gold medals won and the most medals overall. Americans won a total of 39 gold medals and 113 total medals to lead both categories. China finished second with 88 total medals and 38 gold. Legendary college football coach Bobby Bowden died Sunday at the age of 91. Bowden revealed last month that he'd been diagnosed with terminal cancer. He'd already endured a battle with COVID-19 in October of 2020. Bowden coached Florida State for 34 years and was the second winningest coach in Division I history with 357 wins to his credit. Peyton Manning and seven others added the famed Golden Jacket to their closets over the weekend. Manning headlined the 2021 Pro Football Hall of Fame class. Also entering the hall were guard Alan Faneca, coach Tom Flores, receiver Calvin Johnson, safety John Lynch, contributor Bill Nunn, receiver Drew Pearson, and safety Charles Woodson. Here's the schedule for today. In Major League Baseball, the Cubs host the Brewers, White Sox at the Twins, Marlins at the Padres, Yankees at the Royals, and the Reds at the Indians. And fall practices are scheduled to begin today at high schools around the state. At FCHS, cross-country runs from 8 to 9:30 a.m. at Southwest Park, golf from 8 to 10 a.m. at the Fairfield Public Golf Course, volleyball from 9:30 a.m. to noon at Center Street, girls tennis from 3:30 to 5 p.m. at Lakeside Park, and football from 3:30 to 6 p.m. at FCHS. Today is also the first day for football card sales. Cross-country, golf, and girls tennis are, of course, weather permitting. Fall practices also begin today at Sisney High School. Volleyball runs from 8 to 10 a.m. and baseball from 5:30 to 7:30 p.m., weather permitting, of course. All players must have a current physical on file. That is a Monday check of sports. Your Classic Hits Fairfield area weather forecast, a flash flood warning in effect for today. Otherwise, a 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high 87. Partly cloudy tonight, low 72. For tomorrow, mostly sunny, 30% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high 91. Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday, mostly sunny, chance of showers and thunderstorms each day. Highs in the mid-80s to the low 90s each day. Overnight, low 66, yesterday's high 87. Almost 3 inches of rainfall in Fairfield overnight. Around the area, just under 6 inches in Sisney, a little over 4 inches in Albion, almost 5 east of Albion, and about 3.5 west of Albion into the Bone Gap area. Currently, humidity is at 100%, winds out of the southeast at 7 miles an hour, and the pressure at 29.98. Cloudy skies right now in 68 here at the WFIW studios east of Fairfield.
It's early in the morning and I can't get right.
Good morning and welcome to Morning Coffee for a Monday. Galen Dunn is with us. Hey.
Good morning, Mark. How are you?
What's going on?
Oh, it's a beautiful day in Fairfield. Nice rain. Whew.
All right. First, I want to dispel some rumors.
Okay. I'm not taking Jeff Vaughn's place.
Yeah. Jeff Vaughn is still with the station.
He is.
Okay. He's just been on vacation and he'll be back on Wednesday.
Back on Wednesday.
Yeah. Because he was helping you last week, right?
What a guy.
He told me before he left, he goes, you know, the only time I take vacation is to help Colin Dunn move. And I said, how many times has Colin moved?
this is the fourth time. And what a trooper Jeff is. I mean, he's a huge help. And actually, Margaret and I were just, we went only halfway.
You were supervising, weren't you?
Well, no, we worked, but we moved, got everything loaded up, and they moved. They're moving to Searcy, Arkansas, where they are now. But our part of the trip was just from getting them loaded up and moved from Muncie, and then they stopped in Fairfield. But then Jeff continued
on
the trip, yes. And so anyway, he's quite the guy.
You know, he was supposed to. Now I understand his comments, because I thought, you know, maybe they were just moving, you know, down the street.
Oh, or, no.
You know, do another short.
No.
Oh, no. Yeah. Because he told me before he left, he goes, I may have to take Monday and Tuesday off for the next week for just to recoup a little bit.
Sure.
And I just thought to myself, I'm going, really?
What?
And now that I find out he moved all the way to Arkansas. I mean, that's about an 8-hour trip, something like that.
I think it's going to be quite the trip.
And yeah.
The thing is, when we were loading this Penske truck, somehow Jeff and I, we missed a meeting somewhere. I'm not sure what one it was, but Jeff and I ended up inside the truck, and then people were bringing boxes and things and handing them to us. So, you know, here we are in the truck with, like, no air.
Yeah.
And so Jeff and I will rethink that the next time.
Yeah, and last, well, you had decent weather last week.
Yeah, it was nice.
And
it
when
was,
you know, when you go to Muncie, it's it's 10 degrees
cooler. Yeah. It wasn't bad.
But then when you get down to Arkansas, it's 10 degrees warmer.
Yeah, yeah.
And the humidity's about
200%. But Jeff, he was a huge help. What a great friend he's been to Colin. And,
yeah.
You know, I guess I'd probably just throw this out there now. If there's people out there that's needing to move, and Jeff's got a little vacation to use, just call him up. And
Jeff's moving service.
Oh, he has experience. He does. He's a great guy.
Knows what he's doing.
He works cheap.
Does he?
Oh yes,
really?
Absolutely. Yeah, yeah.
Okay. If I ever move, that's who I'm calling. I'm calling JMV.
Hey, we could get little cards made up for him. That's what we need to do.
We should.
Yeah, yeah.
Present him to him when he gets back. Jeff's moving service.
Jeff's moving service.
You call, we haul.
You call, we haul.
So what else has been going on?
it's just been a great summer.
It has been a good summer, hasn't it?
Man, it went by so quickly.
And what about the temps last week? Man, up until about Saturday.
Yeah, I heard Saturday's a little warm in Effingham.
It was a little warm in Effingham. I went up because my grandson's playing JFL football the first year.
Mm-hmm.
So I went up there, and they had their jamboree.
Mm-hmm.
They played 5 games.
Mm. Did you have one of those pop-up tent things?
Eventually.
Yeah.
We get there, and one of his teammates' parents are sitting there.
Uh-huh.
And Mom's just reading Dad the Riot Act. Because Dad is going on about... He's saying, you know, I got one of them pop-up tents. I brought her to sit right down. And Mom's just, what do you mean? About the third game, man, they set that thing up. She didn't move from the shade.
You know, and when you have one of those, you gain friends.
Oh, yeah.
You know.
Just, absolutely.
Now, kind of an aside to this, a little bit of a funny story, because this is morning coffee, right?
Yeah.
Okay, well. I try to be a nice person once in a while, okay?
Well, yeah.
And I'm not a coffee drinker, okay?
Uh-huh.
But my wife, Margaret, she likes coffee. And so she has this thing that she does. It's called a French press coffee.
Okay.
She says it's great. But anyway, so I'm up.
You got to grind the beans and everything.
Well, you
that,
grind
right?
the beans, and you put it in this little thing, and you pour hot water in there, and you put the plunger down. It's a process, but Margaret says it's really smooth.
Okay.
The coffee's smooth. So anyway, just at least twice last week, I kind of got the coffee prepped for her, and then all she had to do was just put the hot water in there, and away she went. And I thought I was doing a great job. Well, then yesterday we were there at the house, and she opened up the cabinet, or I did, and I was going to make coffee, and she said, is that the coffee you've been making for me? I said, yeah. And she said, well, you know, that's decaf you've been giving me. She said, I was really needing the regular. I said, oh, okay.
Number one, Galen, do not use decaf. Number two, dish water is not appropriate for the coffee press.
I use regular water, but she really wanted the caffeine, I think. So I'm going to be a little more, I guess, aware of that now.
Well, it was early in the morning, right?
Yeah, it was. It was early.
Quite awake. Yeah.
Yeah.
This is one of Colin and Jeff's masterpieces.
Ah, okay.
I remember when the show was young. Mark and Jeremy had so much fun. Chopping bands and entering the phone. Called into Mystery Boys was with a guess of my own. But the biggest kick I ever got was from a thing called the Bucket of Bum. All the listeners were looking at the clock while they were waiting for Mark to reach the Bucket of Bum. Well,
sounds like a chicken.
Is that a... It does, doesn't it? Keep waiting for somebody to bring my order out from Chick-fil-A. You want Chick-fil-A sauce with that? Which, by the way, they sell Chick-fil-A sauce at Walmart.
Oh,
I did not know that.
They may even have that at Save-A-Lot.
Ooh.
Maybe.
Okay. I don't go to Walmart very often.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think they do.
Okay. Today is National Book Lovers Day.
Okay.
It is Rice Pudding Day. Mm-hmm. It is International Day of the World's Indigenous People.
Okay.
National Veep Day. International Co-working Day. International Pigtail Day. It's National Handholding Day, and it is National Polka Day.
Hmm.
So we could all do the chicken dance, I guess.
I'm not coordinated to do that.
Yeah. Well, you know, it's like.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. That's a good thing.
Every wedding reception I have ever been to, they play the chicken dance. Celebrity birthdays, 1944, Smokey Bear.
Hmm. Okay.
Advertising campaign of the U.S. or advertising icon of the U.S. Forest Service, the Wildlife Prevention Campaign featuring Smokey Bear is the longest-running PSA campaign in United States history. The Ad Council, the U.S. Forest Service, and the National Association of State Foresters use Smokey to educate the public about the dangers of unplanned human-caused wildfires. He said several different slogans.
Remember, only you can prevent forest fires.
Uh-huh. That was the original.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, no. The original slogan was Smokey says, care will prevent 9 out of 10 forest fires.
Hmm.
Then it changed, and now it's only you can prevent wildfires.
Wildfires, okay.
Yeah. 1930, Betty Boop.
Okay.
Boop, boop, ba-doop. Caricature of a jazz age flapper.
Hmm.
1930 first came out. She was featured in 90 theatrical cartoons between 1930 and 1939. She's also been featured in comic strips, mass merchandising. She was described in a 1934 court case as combining the childish with the sophisticated. A large, round baby face with big eyes and a nose like a button. Sounds like we're talking about Santa Claus.
Yeah.
Framed in a somewhat careful coiffure.
Hmm.
With a very small body of which perhaps the leading characteristic is the most self-confident little bust imaginable.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm. She was toned down a little bit in the mid-30s because of the Hays Code to appear more demure. Clara Bow is often given credit for being the inspiration for Betty, although creator Max Fleischer told his artist that he wanted a caricature of singer Helen Kane, who performed in a style shared by many performers of the day. Kane was also the one that sued Fleischer over the signature Boop Boop A Doop line. First appearance in the cartoon Dizzy Dishes, released on August 9th, 1930. 1963, Whitney Houston, born on the day. She left us in 2012. Singer, songwriter, actress, gigantic hit in her first starring role in the movie The Bodyguard.
The Bodyguard, yeah, that's right.
Mm-hmm. Best song from that movie, I Will Always Love You, the Dolly Parton remake. Of course, she got involved in some things that she didn't really need to get involved with.
Right.
Bobby Brown, drugs.
Mm. Kind of hand in hand there, wasn't it?
Let's see. 1648, Johann Michael Bach was born, the great composer.
Ah, Bach.
Ah, Bach. There you go.
I think that's a line from MASH. Radar used that one time. Ah, Bach.
It's a line from some other movies, too.
Oh, okay.
Okay. 1928, Bob Cousy.
Bob basketball player.
Mm-hmm. Played for the Celtics, mm-hmm. I think his entire career. 1943, Ken Norton, the heavyweight boxer. 1944, Sam Elliott.
Oh.
Mm-hmm.
He was in Lonesome Dove, maybe, or not, no?
I think so. A Star is Born, Conaher. Hmm. And he's probably best known. He was in Roadhouse. He was in the movie We Were Soldiers with Mel Gibson. Probably best known for It's What's for Dinner.
Hmm.
The Beef Guy.
Hmm.
He's the voice of the Beef Council.
Oh, yeah.
1950, Chris Haney, Canadian journalist who created Trivial Pursuit.
That was a fun game.
Yeah. 1964, the Golden Brett. Brett Hall was born. 1967, Neon Deion Sanders was born. A lot of sports birthdays today. First, I think the first and only guy to own a Super Bowl ring and a World Series ring.
Now, did he play for like the Falcons or the Cowboys?
Both.
Did he?
Played for the Falcons and the Braves.
Okay.
And he played for the Cowboys.
Okay.
And let's see, he also played for the Yankees, too.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Neon Deion.
And then he went into a...
That's quite a deal to play two sports like that.
I know. In the same season. Yeah,
and professionally.
Yeah. I mean, the only other guy that really did it in the modern era was Bo Jackson.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm not sure that Bo Jackson played both sports in the same year.
Yeah, I don't remember
that. I think he
played
baseball and then went into football.
Yeah.
On this date in history, 1945, the atomic bomb is dropped on Nagasaki.
Mm-hmm.
1930, we mentioned Betty Boop.
Mm-hmm.
1854, Henry David Thoreau publishes Walden, his series of essays. 1969, five people, including actress Sharon Tate, were found murdered in their home. Charles Manson, several of his followers were convicted. 1936, Jesse Owens won his fourth gold medal, part of the U.S. 4x100-meter relay team. He already had won the 100, 200, and the long jump at the 1936 Summer Olympics in Berlin, and then went, take that, Hitler!
Yeah.
1941, stocking up, Mrs. E. Patero of Prospect Park found out that she bought seven pairs of six silk stockings and put them in her car and then got them stolen.
Okay.
I don't really get that. I don't know. 1974, Gerald Ford became the 38th president of the United States. 1995, Jerry Garcia passed away, lead guitarist and lead singer of the Grateful Dead. 2006, Bruce Willis decided to sue his childhood friend for $1 million. Bruce DiMattia threatened to reveal damaging secrets about Willis unless Bruce paid him $100,000 and bought him a new car.
Some friend.
Yeah. Now, I mean, speak of some friend. DiMattia lived in a house owned by Bruce Willis for free from 2002 to 2006. He managed Bruce Willis's videos, his photographs, and memorabilia.
Hmm.
Apparently, DiMattia refused to leave the premises and had possession of important pictures and possessions that belonged to Bruce Willis. Come on.
Crazy.
Yeah, just crazy. All right. Oh, okay. Today in rock history here. Let's see. Got a few other things.
Okay.
1974, new album releases on this day. Little Feats, Don't Fail Me Now. 1975, Don Kirshner produced the first rock music awards show.
Mm-hmm.
Alternative to the Grammys, Bad Company, Roger Daltrey, and the Eagles were among the winners. 1978, Muddy Waters performed for President Jimmy Carter at the White House. 1986, Queen played the Knebworth Festival. It was the band's last live performance.
What year was that?
1986. 2003, The Who's Roger Daltrey made his Los Angeles stage debut, playing Alfred P. Doolittle in My Fair Lady. And in 2004, Eric Clapton was inducted into the Hollywood Rock Walk in a private ceremony in which his handprints and signature were imprinted in terrazzo marble.
He could play a little guitar, couldn't he?
He could play a little bit. He could play a little bit. Not you know, just... Yeah. He was okay. He was okay.
Yeah, exactly.
You know? I just, you know... Carnaby Square question of the day.
Oh, I didn't hear this one.
Was,
didn't read it. Okay.
Gordy Toombs gave this to me yesterday.
Oh, I saw him Friday evening.
Yeah.
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 What a talented guy.
Yes, he is. Man, yeah. Those angel wings.
I don't know how his wife puts up with him.
I know. Every time I see him or her, every time I see her, I always ask, okay, what's Gordy made you do now?
You're right, yeah.
What's the latest job Gordy has you to do?
Yeah.
Anyway. Almost 4,000 people reached.
Mm-hmm.
15 plus comments.
Okay, that's okay.
Not a lot. Not a lot.
Mm-hmm.
The question was, is it okay to take a cake or a pie to a potluck, cookout, or reunion with a piece taken out? We're going to get some answers. They're coming up.
Here's to a summer season that's been filled with fun, family, and laughter. Carnaby girls are marching on to the next fashion season, but not before marking all summer clothing half price. Adding a new piece to your wardrobe at the end of season usually ends up being your favorite. Check out Brighton's Garden Wings promo too. All summer clothing, now half price. Fairfield's fashion leader, Carnaby Square, downtown Fairfield.
With the Capital One Saver Card, you earn unlimited 4% cash back on dining out, or in 4% back on entertainment, or on popular streaming, and now 3% back at grocery stores, so you can make the cake that makes her day.
Happy birthday to you.
So earn unlimited cash back for going out or staying in with the Capital One Saver Card. Capital One, what's in your wallet?
Terms apply. See CapitalOne.com for details.
Hamilton Memorial Family Clinics are here for you now, during COVID-19, like we've always been, at our clinics in McLeansboro and Carmi. And now, through our virtual care clinic, have a live video chat with your local provider. Ask questions, get a diagnosis, and even get medication prescribed while using your computer, tablet, or smartphone. Also available for behavioral health needs and physical and occupational therapies. Visit hmhospital.org or simply call either of the Hamilton Memorial Clinic locations.
Great values are happening now during Lowe's Summer Savings. Save on select appliance special values. Plus, save an additional $50 when you buy two or more appliances each priced $396 or more. You'll also find new lower prices on ceiling fans, landscape lighting, and more. So shop Lowe's today. Must ask cashier to apply discount in store. Online must use promo code. Can't be combined with any other discounts. See Lowe's.com for exclusions and terms. Valid 7/15 through 8/4. U.S. only.
We have some exciting news. CRHBC Fairfield Community Health Center is offering video visits for patients both new and established. You can now skip the waiting room and have access to a medical professional from your own home. These appointments are available 7 days a week, including evenings and holidays, and can be made on our website, www.crhbc.org. CRHBC is here for you.
In today's environment, being able to do all of your banking from home is not only convenient, but a necessity. People's National Bank makes it easy for you to do your banking without actually going to the bank. From online banking, mobile banking, free mobile deposit, to transferring funds and paying bills, it's easy and convenient for you to do your banking all from your mobile phone or computer. Get started by going to peoplesnationalbank.com to sign up for online banking today. People's National Bank, making it easy to bank from anywhere. Member FDIC.
Have you ever wondered if you're on track for retirement, how much you will need, or when you will be able to retire? Hi, this is Luke Harrell, financial advisor with F&B Asset Management. I'm here to help answer these difficult questions. Our comprehensive retirement planning services help you plan through the entire retirement process, from planning, education, and guidance to 401k rollovers and IRA transfers. We can help you plan today so you're able to enjoy your retirement when the time comes. Call 842-2109 or visit today, F&B Asset Management.
Hi, this is Bill Stevens with another Time Capsule quiz. Which month and year was it when the Trans-Alaska Pipeline opened? Former Attorney General John Mitchell went to jail. President Carter canceled the B-1 bomber. Seattle SLU won the Belmont to complete his triple crown. Portland captured its first NBA title.
The game is over! The Portland Trailblazers have won the World Championship!
Tom Seaver was traded from the Mets to the Reds. And here's what was new on the radio. So, when were all these songs coming out of your radio? The answer and a little nibble of the top song from the month and year are coming up.
The telling someone you love them with McDonald's deal is as rare as it is special, since it's best shown by giving up the last bite, because a gesture like that is a true act of selflessness.
Enjoy one of our $3 bundles, like a McDouble, McChicken, or four-piece chicken McNuggets, each paired with small fries, only at McDonald's. Price and participation may vary.
Ba-da-ba-ba-ba. McDonald's, I'm loving it.
June 1977. Looks like we made it.
Barry Manilow and Looks Like We Made It, the top song of June 1977. This is Bill Stevens for TCapsule.com. Back soon with another Time Capsule.
Want to hear something amazing? Discover matches all the cash back you earn on your credit card at the end of your first year, automatically, dollar for dollar, with no limit on how much you can earn. Extra cash? Come on, how amazing is that? In fact, it's even more amazing when you realize all the places where Discover is accepted. 99% of places in the U.S. that take credit cards. So when it comes to Discover, get used to hearing yes more often. Learn more at discover.com/yes. 2021 Nielsen Report. Limitations apply.
Welcome back to Morning Coffee for the Carnaby Square Question of the Day. There we go. Now I got it. Got us on there. I almost forgot to do that. So, All right, Carnaby Square, of course, is the fashion leader in downtown Fairfield. Here's your question provided to us by Gordy Toombs. Is it okay to take a cake or a pie to a potluck, cookout, or reunion with a piece taken out? Jeremy?
Yeah, you just say it's a Pac-Man pie.
Galen?
You know, I think I'd probably have to say no on that one.
Quality control. We have a lot of that answer. But here's what we do. We take just a little corner out, and then we cover it up with icing. Uh-huh. Leftover icing, so
there
nobody
you go.
Knows
there you go.
That you took a piece
yeah.
out.
Yeah.
Now the you know, the jig's up.
What? The other night when I saw Gordy, he was loading up on desserts. I'm just telling you.
Well, yeah. I know when you go to a potluck. I mean, you go to these places, reunion, potluck, church dinner, whatever. They have these big old gigantic chinette plates for your food. A little bitty tiny place for dessert. I want the sampler platter with the dessert. I want the big plate.
Well, now I did see Gordy. You know, he was kind of policing up the area, of doing people's dishes and getting rid of some things. So he was helpful the other night.
Working for his supper. Then.
He was.
All right. Let's get to some answers. Angela says she's done it if she took it somewhere the day before, like a holiday dinner or something, where they have multiple dinners, and have most of whatever was left over. It's better than bringing it home and letting it go to waste. Doesn't go to waste in my house. Will not go to waste. Connie says, my mom would say definitely no. But I think nowadays most people would be okay with it. Lonnie says, family reunion yes. The cakewalk, no. I get that. Kirk says, yes, because sometimes people won't cut the cake or pie and take a piece out first. They never want to be the first person. I have no qualms.
No problem doing that.
No.
Lyrie says it depends on the event. If it's a family function, not a big deal. If it's a work function, nope, ain't going to do it. Mm-hmm. Tommy says, I mean, that is really the only way to be certain you aren't poisoning the rest of the guests.
That's a good point. Uh-huh. It's a valid point. See, Tommy cares. Mm-hmm.
Jim adds, it's a quality control thing.
Yes.
Zach says, why, yes, you must quality control before you share it with others.
That's right.
Terry says she would never do that. Mike and Lori say, absolutely. Got to test the product, quality control, etc. Darla Jane says, depends on the function, but if a piece is missing, ask Tom.
There you go.
I do have a last name, but I'm not going to say the last name. Reba says, I can't believe anyone would do that. John says, how else are you supposed to know what it is? Okay, yeah. Cindy says, is there any other way? Ron adds that, to ask the question, what are we, hobos? Bill says, wouldn't bother me. And Roger says, no, he would not do it.
Now, I just have to ask you about the one that said, how else are you going to know what it is? If you baked the pie, you should know what it is. If you bought the pie, surely you know what it is.
I think they mean other people at the function.
Oh, I got you.
Oh.
I got you.
I guess.
Okay.
I don't know.
Okay.
So you said earlier you had a couple of stories. You gave us one.
Well, and you know, and Jeff Vaughn, what a guy. I mean, you know, vacation to help Colin move, and and then one thing I was concerned about was they needed packing blankets and things like that for the move. And so we had several at our house, and so we let them use those. Then I was kind of concerned about, okay, will I ever see those again? And, you know, had ratchet straps and all these things.
Jeff Vaughn had brought stuff in.
Yeah, he did. And he was really good about that. There were some things from the freezer that they had put in a cooler, and so they used that. But the thing that I'm disappointed in Jeff about is, okay, I got the blankets and all these things back, but in the cooler there were no steaks.
It was empty.
It was empty. I thought sure there would be steaks in there.
You know, if you borrow a cooler, you should have
return
to
it full.
Return
That's
it full.
Right. That's
and,
right.
I mean, I know that, you know, Jeff was raised on some good prime beef.
Yeah.
And and he has access to that, and I just thought sure he would do that. And
so what you're saying is, it's Jeff Vaughn's fault that we didn't get steak and potatoes today.
That's exactly right.
Okay.
Let's see, what else? There were a couple that. it's Jeff's fault.
He's got a whole list.
Look at this.
That's right.
The other thing is, we're starting a school year. Can you believe that?
Yes.
I know that.
I mean, school starts this week.
Yeah, for my grandchildren. Yeah, this week, Wednesday.
Earlier every year.
I mean, we're looking at junior high ball games
starting
either late this week or early next week. It's here.
And let's just hope that it's as normal year as it can be for everyone.
I hope so.
Yes, I hope so.
Yeah, that would be just wonderful.
Yeah. Now, right now, they're going to have to wear a mask, but that's it.
Right.
And mask indoors.
Mm-hmm.
So, I mean, when you go outside and play,
right, you
can play without a mask right now.
Just what a mess, you know.
Yeah.
Don't want to dwell on that. Let's see. What else do I have here? I went to the Wayne White co-op thing Friday evening.
How were the pork chops?
Good. It was not held indoors. It was a drive-through thing.
They had like a drive-in set up for the entertainment, right?
But everything was very well organized, as I knew it would be with Wayne White Co-op. Yeah. So hopefully these functions will kind of get back to more normal and nothing will be affected by all of this. But they handle it very well.
Okay.
And lots of people adjust to that. They just adjust to the situation.
So this woman out of Russia. is suing McDonald's.
Okay.
Yep. Saying one of their ads tempted her into breaking her fast during Lent.
Wow.
Yeah.
Hmm.
The woman says, and I'm not even going to try and
I thought maybe it was because they fed her moose and squirrel.
Nope. The woman says she was adhering to Lent.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, which of course forbids meat, dairy, and similar products for a month when she noticed a billboard.
Mm-hmm.
The woman said she just couldn't resist and had to get a burger. Now, she is suing McDonald's. And she is asking for $14.
The price of the meal?
I guess.
So now instead of the devil made me do it, it's Ronald McDonald made me do
there
it.
There you go. Uh-huh. It's all Ronald's fault.
Yep. Ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
In the suit, it says McDonald's breached a consumer protection law and caused her moral damage.
A consumer protection law. Mm-hmm. That's a very bold.
We are a very litigious society.
Yes.
And have you seen the latest TikTok challenge?
No, but I'll have to say I don't keep up with TikTok.
Well, let's just put it this way. If you try it, it could cause some potty problems.
Oh, my.
Mm-hmm.
Something must be going in somewhere.
Yeah, and coming out somewhere with great regularity.
Hey.
So what they're doing is you fill up a water bottle with honey, and then you freeze it. After it's frozen, you squeeze it out and you eat it. You eat the whole water bottle full of honey. It's a lot of honey. Health officials say honey is great in small doses, but eating too much is in one sitting is a lot of sugar to process and could lead to stomach cramping, bloating, diarrhea, and other side effects.
Wow.
So kids don't try this at home.
Freezing's the problem here or what?
Oh, eating too much honey.
So, I mean, it could be frozen or...
Yeah. Frozen or regular, just don't eat too much.
But in the TikTok video, they're freezing.
Okay.
I guess they break open.
It's a honey of a tip there, Mark.
Yeah. So you have trivia for us, Galen?
I have two different themes of trivia today.
Okay.
So are you ready?
Yeah, bring
Let's
it
do
on.
It.
Give us the questions.
Okay. Hang on just a second. Yeah. You get old, you have to wear glasses. Okay. Some of these we may have had before, and I may have more than 10, okay?
Okay.
Do we have a Sheldon coming on or anything?
We do have talked with Jeff Black.
Jeff Black, okay. Yeah. How tall is the Gateway Arch?
All right.
When did it open? What year?
Okay.
How many blocks were demolished to build the arch and its surrounding park? How many blocks? How many people died in the construction?
You mean cement blocks, right?
Yeah. How many people died in the construction process? And what was the cost to build it when it was built?
Okay.
Now, another show. This is a show. What company was the sponsor of Wild Kingdom?
Oh, I know that one. Came on right before Disney's.
What
Wonderful World of Disney.
What years were the show on?
All right.
Who were the hosts?
Okay.
And then there's some like sub questions for that.
Okay.
Whose image is on the $2 bill?
All right.
Okay.
And then if we need some filler, I've got some product slogans and their taglines.
Okay.
All right.
I like them. I might do okay.
I know one.
Tagline?
I know one. No.
The answer?
I know one answer.
You'll know more than that.
At Lowe's, we know your home is an expression of you, and we see you walking down these aisles of possibility, running your finger on that marble top Allen and Roth vanity, regularly $5.99, but now $3.49, and finding that perfect rattan pendant at an everyday low price of $99.98. In our showrooms of style, you'll find whatever you're into at a price you'll really get into. Lowe's, home to any budget, home to any possibility. Selection varies by location. While supplies last, see associate at Lowe's.com for details. Valid through 8/29/21. U.S. only.
Get the good stuff.
Spring is battery season at Napa. Stop by our locations in Fairfield, Wayne City, and Carmine for smoking deals on lawnmower, golf cart, and marine batteries. Lawnmower batteries start at $23.99. Golf cart batteries start at $99.99. And marine batteries start at $73.99. Ready to start spring cleaning? We have pressure washers with a Honda motor on sale for $359.99. Come get some Napa know-how and save today.
Napa, get the good stuff.
Midtown Package Liquors is now open in Fairfield. Stop by and see the products and largest selection in town. They have the coldest beer cave with a large selection of cold beer, so it is ready to drink. Top quality roll-your-own tobacco products are available for purchase. Midtown Package Liquors is proud to be the newest store in town on Main Street. So stop by and shop local. Midtown Package Liquors, open now in Fairfield. North American Lighting will host open interviews for assembly operators on Wednesday, August the 11th from 8 a.m. until 4 p.m. at their Flora facility. NAL operators start out making $17 per hour plus world-class benefits and work in the comfort of a clean, climate-controlled facility. Don't miss your chance to interview with your next employer of choice on Wednesday, August 11th from 8 a.m. until 4 p.m. To speed up the interview process, go ahead and apply online at NAL.com.
Jeff Adrenaline Black. Pumping, heart racing, and up-close entertainment is coming to Palestine. It's the Labor Day Weekend Rodeo. On Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, the Professional Championship Rodeo will have a new rodeo performance each day starting at 7 p.m. Central Time. For tickets, call 618-586-2222 or visit pioneercity.com/rodeo. Call today at 618-586-2222 or order online at pioneercity.com.
It's time to talk with Jeff Black from Le Mans Chevrolet Chrysler.
Good morning.
Good morning, Mark. How are you doing this morning?
I'm all right. I see you're still making Sheldon stay away.
Yeah.
I bet you've doubled the amount of cars you've sold this week, haven't you?
Yes. Yeah, I have. I think maybe tripled, actually. But
so what do you got going on besides swimming around in the lot with all that rain we had?
Right now I'm trying to keep a couple of employees from getting too upset with me. You know, we've been a little short on cars.
Right.
And I think I accidentally sold two of them, our employees' cars last week. And I'm going to have to find something to replace them with, evidently. They said that they live far enough away they wasn't going to walk to work. So right now they're in my truck.
All right. But I guess you've got a huge selection of used vehicles and some nice new vehicles on the lot as well.
We got lucky here lately. We got a couple of new Silverados just recently came in, Chevy Silverados. We've got a few Ram trucks sitting around here still new. I think we've got a Durango, new Durango sitting out there. Looks pretty sharp. And then you're right, Mark, on the used side, we've got some pretty nice trucks, used Chevy trucks, some Ram trucks. We've got a couple of Tahoes. They've got a few miles on them, but their local trades have been well-maintained. And then there's if you're looking for something a little bit more higher end, a 2017 Cadillac XT5. That's your crossover, your mid-size crossover. And, you know, those Cadillacs are kind of expensive, and you can get this one for only $30,000. So,
what a deal. What a bargain.
That's not too bad for a Cadillac XT5.
It is not.
Yes, they're very luxurious and much a pleasure to drive down the road.
Those got those souped-up engines in them, don't they?
Yeah, let's see. That one there, let me look here. I think it's just got two or three turbos on it. And it's got the 3.6 V6, which is rated at 315 horsepower in that vehicle.
So you'll have no problem passing somebody on the interstate?
No, you might want to use that cruise control because the state troopers might catch up with you eventually.
All right. Jeff, as always, we appreciate you joining us. Have a great week. And I don't know, we may or may talk to you on Thursday.
We'll see what's happening. Remember, you'll like the way we do business.
Radar Weather is sponsored by Conard Financial Group at 510 West Delaware in Fairfield, with securities offered through Raymond James. Conard Financial Group, investing in the community since 2003.
Does your financial future depend on the performance of a single investment? In any type of market, allocating your investments among a variety of assets may help minimize risk. I understand the importance of asset allocation and can design a diversified portfolio based on your risk profile to help you attain your goals. For details, call me, Chris Conard, at 842-7855. That's 842-7855. Raymond James Financial Services, Inc., member FINRA, SIPC. Life well planned.
Flash flood warning in effect for the area today. A 50% chance of showers and thunderstorms, high 87. Partly cloudy tonight, low 72. Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday looking pretty good. Mostly sunny each day. There is a slight chance of showers and thunderstorms. Highs Tuesday, Wednesday, and Thursday in the low 90s. Friday, we drop down to the mid-80s for a high. Overnight low was 66. Yesterday's high, 87. 3 inches of rainfall here in the Fairfield area, a lot more to the north and west and east of us. Right now, humidity at 100%, winds out of the southeast at 6 miles an hour, and the pressure at 29.98. Clouds right now at 70 at the WFIW studios east of Fairfield. Radar showing a little rain off to the west and south of us. Most of it is hanging off to the north. Radar weather has been brought to you by the Conard Financial Group. All right, Galen, take it away.
Hey, just want to say thank you for a couple things.
Yeah.
Actually, about three. Thanks for having me on this morning.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Then, we're always glad to have Galen Dunn on.
A couple weeks ago, thanks for having my nephew Hunter on. He had such a time here. He loves it. And you all are very nice to include him in this when he's up here. And thanks. That's really special for him and his family. So,
you know, I hate that every time he's up, I'm either on location or at a different studio. I missed him again. So, Hunter, I promise I'll try to see you next time,
okay,
buddy.
Okay, great.
All right.
And let's see. The Friday theme music. Thanks for continuing to play that.
Oh, we are happy to play that.
Yes. I love that music. All right. Questions. Jeremy, how many questions are you going to get correct today?
Two. I feel confident in one and half and half,
okay,
on another.
All right. So, how tall is the Gateway Arch?
Not a clue.
Close to 500 feet, isn't it?
Sort of.
I know it's taller than 300 feet because it's got a light at the top.
630 feet tall.
Okay. Well, that's close. That's
and it's, boy, if you've never been there, it's just great to go over there. It's a beautiful area.
How ironic. It's 630 feet tall. Mm-hmm. What's the area code over by St. Louis?
630.
Yeah.
And
wow,
the base is 630 feet wide.
Okay. I didn't know that.
I did not either.
Just some things about it. It's the tallest monument in the United States.
Hmm.
Okay.
And it's the tallest arch in the world.
Really?
Yeah.
All right.
I'd say the second tallest arch is in Baghdad.
Is it?
Yes, it is.
Okay. See, I didn't know that.
I didn't know that either.
Yes.
All right.
Wow.
What year did it officially open?
1965.
October 26th of 65, wasn't it?
I don't know the date. 65 is correct. This, I didn't think about this, but how many blocks were demolished to build the arch and the surrounding park? And this is an area that I think that kind of had a blight to it anyway. I mean, it wasn't a nice area.
Right. I'm going to say 20 square blocks.
I have no clue.
40 blocks.
40?
Wow.
I was half right.
And but it is a national park.
Yes, it is.
Mm-hmm. How many people died in the construction process?
None.
That is correct. Zero.
Really?
And you look at some of the pictures, and there was not a lot of safety materials going on there.
There wasn't. It's like watching them old pictures, old films, the guys walking on the Empire State Building while they're building that thing. Just walking around.
No safety belts. No
back when that's back when the buildings were made of wood and the men were made of steel.
And I'll give you a range on this. When it was built, how much did it cost?
$1.6
million. $311,000.
$13 million.
Wow.
And just a few years ago, they did a renovation of it.
The renovation was probably twice that.
Over $100 million.
Wow.
Okay. Now, what company was a sponsor of Wild Kingdom
Mutual of Omaha. Omaha.
There you go.
Yes.
You know, we're watching this some on Sunday evenings on RFD TV. Just, it's interesting.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Last night we watched one, and there was an episode of them timing different animals on how fast they would go. And there were no radar guns, so here they are with a Jeep, you know. Yep, they're going 40 mile an hour.
I figured they were making Jim run.
Jim, he always got the worst jobs, I'm telling you.
Right?
Kind of a range of what years were the show on?
I'm going to go with 1963 to about 1974.
I'm going to say 70 to 83.
You're both in a range. It's 63 to 73, but then after 73, then it did continue into the early 80s, but with a different host.
Oh, okay.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm, mm-hmm. And so who were the hosts?
Marlon Perkins.
Yep.
And Jim.
Jim Fowler.
Jim Fowler, okay.
Yes.
Now, what two zoos was Marlon Perkins the director of?
One was St. Louis.
I'm going to just make a guess and say San Diego.
No. It's St. Louis is one, and Lincoln Park Zoo was where he was a director first, and then for the remainder of the time he was a director at St. Louis, and then, as you see on the shows, some of them he's a director emeritus from 1970 to when he died in 86.
Wow. Hmm.
So what other show did Jim Fowler frequently appear on?
It was a fishing show, wasn't it?
Just think about this. He was on this show over 40 times. He would always bring an animal, and it was always
Johnny Carson.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, he would bring that.
My next guess was Fear Factor.
There'd be a lot of Fear Factor with me on some of those things, I'm telling you. Whose image is on the $2 bill?
Hamilton.
I was going to say Alexander Hamilton.
Thomas Jefferson.
Really?
And it's,
I didn't know that.
There's an interesting story with this. Bill Cole, a man that lives here in town, Jim Cole's brother. A few weeks ago, we were in McDonald's.
Mm-hmm.
My wife was with our granddaughter, and Bill comes up and says, hey, if you can tell me, to my granddaughter, whose image is on the $2 bill, I'll give you a $2 bill. Our granddaughter is going to be in third grade, and she said, I don't know. And he said, well, it's Thomas Jefferson. So fast forward a couple of weeks. My granddaughter and I happen to be in McDonald's, and here comes Bill Cole up, and he said, hey, to Sagan, he said, if you can tell me whose image is on the $2 bill, I'll give it to you.
Hmm.
She says, Thomas Jefferson, and he hands her a $2 bill. So,
wow.
And he says he does that with a lot of kids. And I think that's a neat thing that Bill does.
That is neat.
That is awesome.
That is pretty cool.
Okay. Yeah. You want some slogans and taglines?
Yeah, sure. Give us a couple of them.
Okay. The quicker picker upper.
Bounty.
See, you get more than one or two.
Well, now we're talking my language. I sat in front of the TV a lot as a kid.
A little dab will do you.
Little dab will do you. Isn't that
Brill Cream? Brill Cream.
Efferdent. The denture.
Nope.
No.
Brill Cream is
really.
Actually,
yeah.
I thought it was okay.
Melts in your mouth, not in your hands.
M&M's.
Okay.
The Breakfast of Champions.
Wheaties.
Yeah. Good till the last drop.
Maxwell House.
Very good. The best part of waking up
is Folgers in your cup.
Yep. There you go. And this is one I didn't know. First they're sour, then they're sweet.
Trolleys.
Sour Patch Kids.
Sour Patch Kids.
All right.
Very good.
All right. Galen, thanks for joining us.
Thanks for having me, fellas.
All right.
Really enjoyed it.
We'll see you tomorrow.
Have a good day.
Hey Alexa, play WFIW.
It's time for classic hits from WFIW.
News, talk, sports, and classic rock. This is the station listened to, not just heard. 104.9 WFIW Fairfield, Illinois.
Time now for the news, brought to you by Boyd Furniture and Mattress Center in downtown Wayne City. See pictures and prices on BoydFurn.com or follow them on Facebook.
News. I'm Lillian Wu. By tomorrow morning, there could be Senate approval for a bipartisan infrastructure package.
Funding around $1 trillion of core infrastructure, roads, bridges, rail, and broadband. Republican Senator Bill